Hello everybody, welcome to Brainy Dental. In the previous lecture we discussed the operative hand instruments, so in this lecture we talk about the instrument formula, grasps and the bevels. So let's go ahead. G.V. Black gave instrument formula describing the dimensions and angulations of the hand instrument. The instrument formula is placed on the handle in a code of 3 or 4 numbers separated by spaces or dashes. You can see it here, it is placed here. Now, when do we use 3-number formula and when it is 4-number? It is very simple. Now, you observe both the photographs of the two instruments that I have given. The first is a chisel, this is the blade and the cutting edge. Now, this cutting edge is perpendicular to the blade. Now, the second photograph is that of an enamel hatchet, this is the blade and the cutting edge. Again, the cutting edge is perpendicular to the blade. So, in both these conditions, you see that the cutting edge of the instrument is perpendicular to the long axis of the blade. In this situation, the instrument formula will have 3 numbers. In case the cutting edge is at some other angle other than 90 degrees, then the instrument formula has 4 numbers. That's it. Let us discuss each number of the formula in detail. The first number, it is the blade width and it is measured in 1/10 of the millimeter. So this is the width of the blade and it is 20, the first number. So it will be 20 upon 10 and that comes to 2 millimeter. So your width is 2 millimeter. The second number is the blade length and it is measured in millimeters. So number 7 means that your length of the blade is 7 millimeter. And the third number, it is the blade angle. And the blade angle is measured in clockwise centigrade. Now, what is a blade angle? Now, blade angle is basically the angle made by the long axis of the blade with the long axis of the handle. This is the blade angle. And the fourth number, in case it is present, it is the cutting edge angle and it's also measured in clockwise centigrade. Let me explain to you the concept of clockwise centigrade. You know that a circle is of 360 degrees. Now, for learning simplification, the astronomical compass of 360 degrees was substituted by a Celsius compass of 100 degrees. So, this circle is divided into 100 parts. 0, 25, 50 and 75. So whatever number or whatever the angle it turns out to be, it is expressed as a percentage of 360 degree. That means number 14 means 14% of 360, which is 50 degree. If it was number 25, then it would be 25% of 360 or 90 degree. So I hope you followed this concept of clockwise centigrade. Let us discuss the fourth number of the formula. The fourth number represents the cutting edge angle and this comes into picture when the cutting edge is at an angle other than 90 degrees. Now, what is the cutting edge angle? Now, if you concentrate at the photograph, the cutting edge angle, it is the angle made by the cutting edge like this with the long axis of the handle. So, this is your cutting edge angle. Now, in this case, the cutting edge angle turns out to be 88 degrees. Now, this is also represented in clockwise centigrade. And when cutting edge angle is present or when the fourth number is present, it is placed between the first and the second number in the formula. So, our formula was 27 and 14. So, 88 will be now placed between the first and the second number, that is 20 and 7. And the formula becomes 20, 88, 7 and 14. Now, in this case, 88 means 88% of 360, that is 306.8 degree centigrade. G.V. Black classified instruments by a name. Now, he gave a name in which the instrument could be completely described by that one name. It could tell the function of that instrument, whether it was an excavator, a scaler, a condenser, a burnisher, or then the manner of use, whether it is used with hand or rotary, then design of the working end. Now, spoon excavator means the working end is spoon shaped, or a ball burnisher in which the working end is ball shaped. Then shape of the shank, whether it is mono angled or bine angled. and then he combined all these words together to formulate the name. Now let's look at this example. This instrument, it is a binangle spoon hand excavator. That means it has shank has two angles. It is binangle. The working end is spoon shaped. It is used with the form of help of a hand, and it performs the function of excavating caries. Similarly, you can have binangle cylindrical hand condenser. So this is instrument name given by G.B. Black. Discuss the instrument bevels. Now presented here on the slide are two instruments, the chisel, the straight chisel, and the enamel hatchet. Now both these instruments, they bear a single bevel at the end of their blade. You can see it here. And this single bevel is the primary cutting edge. And such instruments, they are called single beveled instruments. We just discussed that this is the primary cutting edge. In case there are two additional bevels extending from the primary cutting edge along the length of the blade like this, we call them secondary cutting edges. These allow cutting in three directions as per the requirement, and they improve the cutting efficiency of the instrument. Let us discuss the right and the left bevel. You see, single beveled instruments like the enamel hatchet as shown in the photograph, they are made in pairs. And they have bevels on the opposite side of the blade indicating the right and the left side. What I mean to say is this is an instrument here and here. So one end would be right side bevel, other end would be having a left side bevel. Now it is a single beveled instrument in which the blade has only one bevel. Now these single beveled instruments, they occur in pairs, the right and the left side. Now how do we determine which is the working side? To determine the right and the left side of the instrument, you hold the instrument like this with the cutting edge facing downwards away from the operator. Now you see where the blade, the cutting edge on the blade is pointing. Now in this case, it is pointing here on the right side. So this is right ended. And if you hold it like this, here the cutting edge is facing the left side, so this is left handed. So I hope you have followed this, the right and the left handed single beveled instrument. Bibeveled instruments. Now these are those instruments that have two bevels that form the cutting edge. So you can see one bevel is present here and the other bevel is present here. So example is an ordinary hatchet and these two bevels, so you can see they are meeting here at one point to form a sharp end. Triple beveled instruments. These are those instruments which have three distinct cutting edges. The instrument is beveled at its end here, which is the primary cutting edge, and it is beveled along its lateral surfaces, the secondary cutting edges. And the example for this is the angle former. Circumferentially beveled instruments. Now these are double planed instruments in which the blade is beveled all along its periphery. For example, a spoon excavator. Instrument grasps. It means how you grasp or hold the instrument while you're working in a patient's mouth. Now there are three popular types of instrument grasps: the modified pen grasp, the inverted pen grasp, and the palm and thumb grasp. Now coming first to the modified pen grasp. Now in this, the instrument is held like you're holding a pen, but the middle finger is placed near the top side of the instrument. Let me show you. Now you look at the photograph and you will observe that the middle finger, the pad of the middle finger, is placed in front of the index finger, and this middle finger is placed near the top side of the instrument. Now the importance of this is that this position helps in controlling the motion of the instrument, and it helps in exerting cutting pressure to the blade while we are working in the mouth. Another thing you'll observe is that the palm of the hand here, it is facing away from the operator. So this is your modified pen grasp. You pick up your pen and you can practice it while you look at this photograph. The inverted pen grasp. Now it is similar to the modified pen grasp, except that the hand is rotated such that the palm of the hand is facing the operator. So this was our modified pen grasp, and this will be the inverted pen grasp. We have rotated the hand. Now this kind of grasp is useful when you are preparing the anterior teeth from the lingual approach. Palm and thumb type of grasp. Now as the name suggests, the handle of the instrument is placed in the palm of the hand and it is grasped by all the fingers. You can see it in the photograph. The handle is placed in the palm and grasped by all the fingers, whereas the thumb is free to act as a rest. The rest is provided by the tip of the thumb placed on a nearby tooth of the same arc. Now it works in a manner similar to the method that we use while holding a knife while we are peeling an apple. Now this type of grasp is usually used in an area of maxillary arc, and it is best adopted when the dentist is operating from a rear chair position. That means the dentist is positioned behind the head of the patient and he's working in the maxillary arc. That's all in this lecture. I hope you enjoyed it. All the data in this presentation has been taken from textbook of Operative Dentistry written by me. The link of it has been given in the description box below. Also, check out the videos on operative hand instruments and cast class to cavity preparation. And if you like this video, do share it with your friends and subscribe right here. Thank you.